patients, when they're first told that they have prostate cancer, generally don't hear anything else for the rest of the consultation. And so in actual fact, we now have set up a more streamlined pathway whereby when patients come back for their results, they actually see one of our nurse specialists who tells them the diagnosis and what treatment tests we need to arrange for staging the tests, for staging the cancer. So they would then know whether or not it was a low-risk prostate cancer that in fact did not need any staging, or a higher-risk prostate cancer that needed the CT scan or the bone scan. And they would arrange that within a very short period of time and come back and see me with the results. They would give the patient a booklet so that they could read up on some of the options and think of some questions that they might want to ask in advance, and perhaps talk to them about some of the options that they might wish to discuss. So by the time the patients come to see me, they've usually written down questions that they want on the advice of the nurse specialist, and have a good idea of the treatment options. So it helps to make that interview process a lot more worthwhile. The emotional side of things becomes apparent really during the interview process, where the patient may volunteer certain things that are very important to them. And those issues may then help them to make a decision between treatments, surgery versus radiotherapy, for example. And there may be things that we can discuss, and there's some flexibility about when they have their treatment or which treatment we would recommend, or there may not. Patients that are now coming to see me with, for example, prostate cancer, are much younger than they used to be, now that it's being detected with the PSA test. So many of them are at work and fitting in, either continuing with their work is an issue, or those patients that can't afford to take time off work, those sort of issues can affect patients. Equally, there may be a family history of patients who have, say, died with a similar cancer that may affect their views on radiotherapy, surgery, or chemotherapy, and that can influence whether they would like to go through certain treatments or not. So that all comes out, and if there is any choice or options, one would consider that.